What's going on, guys? It's Omniarch, and today I'm giving you the giveaway announcement. I mentioned on Twitter the other day that I would be ending the giveaway on, I believe, Wednesday or Thursday. I said the deadline was, and here we are. The deadline is over, it is passed, and I'm announcing the winners of the Shadow Contest. So, if you guys didn't know, a few weeks ago, I think it was about 2 or 3 weeks ago, or 2.5 weeks ago, I don't know, I did a contest, and I said, hey, you know, everyone's asking me for shoutouts, here's how you can get one, and I started a contest. I asked you guys to make a video, you know, preferably a gameplay commentary, talking about something that you love, and I think we got about 13 submissions, which is definitely more than I thought I would get, which is awesome, so I'm really happy that you guys, you know, took the opportunity to make a video and submit it to me, and I watched all the videos that you guys send me. I've even watched a couple of them multiple times, and I said I would announce 3 winners, and I'm going to tell you that I lied. I'm actually going to announce 4 winners for the contest, so 4 out of 13 is good. That's about 33%. So, you know, I couldn't pick only 3, and even 4 was hard, and I know now, I see why people, you know, when they do giveaways, they just do a random number generator, and I think that's how I'm gonna do it from now on, because it's really hard to pick, you know, subjectively which are the best. You know, it feels messed up. I feel like, you know, a lot of you guys actually put effort into your videos and you tried pretty hard, and I feel bad saying that you didn't win because I liked your video, you know what I'm saying? So from now on, I think I'm just gonna stick to the number generator thing, remove my opinion out of it so that way I don't feel bad, but I did narrow it down to 4 people that I want to announce as the winners, and the first one that I want to talk about, his name is Big Reed. So in Big Reed's submission video, he talks about how he's been on YouTube for 1 year, and how he's super thankful for his friends and everybody that's been supporting his YouTube channel so far. He's talked about a couple of people that helped him out with equipment, and some people that, you know, have kept him grounded and have kept him, you know, grinding towards his goal of growing on YouTube. And the big thing about this guy, and I've actually, the funny part is, I've actually seen his videos before. There was a time, I think a month or two ago, where I ran across his Twitter, and I believe he follows me and I follow him. I'm not entirely sure. I'll go back and check after this video, but I ran into his Twitter, and I checked out his channel, and I didn't mention this to him at all, I don't think, but I watched one or two of his videos, and they were really good, and I enjoyed them. So to see that he actually submitted a, you know, a contest entry to this was awesome. And yeah, he basically just talked about how he was really grateful for his friends that support him and people that, you know, like I said, keep him grinding and things along those lines. I really do like his content, and I highly encourage you guys to go check him out. He does Call of Duty gameplay videos, just like I do on this channel, and he's got a really awesome voice. I don't know if that's weird to say. I think he's in high school, that's my best guess, but he's got a really awesome commentary voice, and he has a really good microphone. The actual submission video that he submitted doesn't have the best audio because I think his mic was broken or something along those lines for that specific video, but if you watch any of the other videos that he has more recently, they are really high quality, and his voice sounds very, very professional, very good, and you definitely should go check him out if you're looking for a new Call of Duty commentator that you can watch on the regular. He has 76 subscribers at the time of making this video, so hopefully you guys will bump that up. Let's get him closer to 100. He definitely deserves it. Again, like I said, he's been grinding for a year now, so let's get him a couple of more subs over there, and hopefully you guys will check him out and really enjoy it. One last thing I want to mention about him before I move on to the next contest winner is that he really reminds me of myself when I was in high school. I always played Call of Duty, I always played video games, and I always had this passion to make YouTube videos, and I didn't really take it seriously until about a year and a half ago, maybe a little bit more than that, and it just, when I watch his videos, I kind of feel like that, like, I feel that connection there, you know what I'm saying? Like, I can relate to his current position and, like, what he's, you know, going through with his channel, so that's just, like, it felt cool to be able to see, you know, it reminded me of when I had 76 subscribers, and I was, you know, putting out videos, trying to get noticed and things like that, and it's really awesome. So if you guys have been around since the beginning of my channel, maybe you'll also see that kind of connection there, and you'll enjoy that content as well. The next winner of the contest goes by the name of Dylan Shark. Now, this video is actually the first one that I ever got. He was the first person to submit a video to this contest. It is a double, I'm looking at it right now, it is a double raps commentary. It is a great video. He absolutely destroys it with the ICR, and he has a great commentary. I think it's like 8 Yeah, 8.5 minutes long. And he talks about the NBA, his love for basketball, and things along those lines, you know, sports, stuff like that. And it was just a great commentary. It actually inspired me to hop on Black Ops 3 and try out the ICR. Like, that's how good of a video it was. And the crazy part is this video is his fourth video. And he's made a ton of videos since this one came out on May 23rd. He's made a lot of videos since then, and he only has 19 subscribers. So he's a brand new YouTuber. And normally, when I give a shout out, I want to give a shout out to somebody that's been doing it for a while. You know, like the last guy, Dylan, or, not Dylan, Big Reed, he actually was on it for a year. You know, I want to see consistency and longevity in a channel. But this commentary was just really good. It sounded really professional. It was really well done. He's well spoken. And it seems like talking comes very naturally to him. So I just really enjoyed the video. And even though he's a new channel and he doesn't have that many videos on his channel, I couldn't say no. The third shout out winner that I'm going to be talking about in this video is Truthfully COD. Now, he made a video talking about what he loves, and his whole video was talking about Call of Duty. He says that, you know, he's in high school, you know, he can come home, play Call of Duty, and kind of just like, you know, get away from the whole high schooler life thing. And it's a great video. He talks very well. I enjoyed the commentary and I enjoyed the gameplay. He has currently, I think, 20 or 21 subscribers right now, but he's been doing YouTube for like a year. So again, that longevity for me is important. If I'm going to give you a shout out, I want to see that you've been doing it for a long time. So, you know, that's super awesome. I'm really glad that I can, you know, I was able to find out about his channel. I think you guys would really enjoy it. So definitely go in the description below and check out all these channels that I've talked about before. And without further ado, let's get to the fourth and final winner of this contest. Now, before I talk about the last winner of the contest, I want to mention that his channel is not Call of Duty related. So I added this person in because it is kind of different. Now, I know that most of the people on my channel are here for Call of Duty, and obviously you enjoy that game, right? But there's some of you that actually want me to play other games, and I'm working on it. I'm trying to figure out what the right balance is and things along those lines. But maybe you guys are a little bit younger, you like Nintendo games, you like other sort of side-scroller games, you know, platforming games, things along those lines, and that's why I wanted to pick at least one person who didn't just do Call of Duty. That way, you know, if you guys are here, you get your Call of Duty fix from my channel, or T-Mart and whoever else, you know, does Call of Duty. If you want to watch something other than Call of Duty, check out this guy's channel. His name is Conman Gaming. He has about 65 subscribers at the time of making this, and I really enjoyed his video that he made for me. It was scripted. He even said that he wrote a script for the video. He talked about how he loved video games and how, you know, it started from him getting, you know, his first console and getting a DSi and getting a Wii, and how much he loved the Wii when that came out. And he basically just like went through and talked about how he appreciated his parents for buying him the consoles that he has. And it was a really well done video. I really enjoyed it. And I think that if you guys, you know, maybe you want to watch something else, something that isn't Call of Duty, he would be a great channel to go check out. He's been doing YouTube for a very long time. Again, like 65 subscribers at the time of making this video for me. So if you guys want to check out something new, something different, then definitely go check out his channel. So that's it, guys. Those are the four winners of the shoutout contest. Make sure you go in the description below and check out all of their YouTube links. They will all be there. I really encourage you to go subscribe to them. You know, they really deserve some more views, some more support, and some more subscribers on their channel. And if I can help them get that, then I'd be more than welcome to. So again, those are the best submissions that I saw. And again, there's more, you know, people that submitted videos that I wish I could, you know, give winners to. But again, the whole point of this contest is that I can't give shout outs to every single person. So those are the four best videos that I think deserved a shout out, and also that I think you guys would enjoy watching. You know, there were some people that submitted a video that was really good, but their channel wasn't something that I think you guys might like, or it was just very different or something along those lines. So I really do appreciate everybody who submitted a video, and if you didn't win, don't get discouraged. Your video was great. I promise you, I watched all of them. They were all very good videos. make sure that you keep grinding, keep at it, keep going, keep making YouTube videos, and continue to improve, continue to grow, and continue to get the word out there about your channel. You know, your time will come with enough time. You have the opportunity and the ability to continue to grow without shoutouts and without, handouts and things like that. You know, they definitely help, and I really hope that you guys will help out the people in the description. But, you know, if you keep grinding, somebody will notice and you will get shoutouts eventually. So if you guys didn't win, again, just keep at it, keep grinding, keep growing and keep going, and I think you guys will start to see success in enough time. Now, one of the submissions is from a very close friend of mine. He's actually my cousin, so even closer than friends. Phenom7Gaming, he's done a couple of videos with me. He's mainly in my Grand Theft Auto series. We play Grand Theft Auto together. I know I have to get that video up, the third part. I'm fully aware that I haven't done one in a long time, but that's not the point of this. He submitted a video. It was just like a quick camera vlog, and he basically told me, what makes me happy, what makes me, you know, keep going, what is something that is positive in my life. And I told him on Twitter, I responded to him on Twitter saying I would talk about it in this video, in the announcement video. So without further ado, let's talk about what makes me happy. Obviously, you know, friends and family are incredibly important, and that's something that a lot of the submissions that I got mentioned. You know, they said like I love my family and I love my friends and all that, and then they went on to talk about something else, because obviously if I got 12 or 13 or 14 videos of people talking about how much they love their family, it would get a little bit boring. So I'm glad that people, you know, mentioned it but talked about something else, and that's one thing that I want to talk about. I'm very grateful for, you know, close friends that I have that I can go to and talk to whenever I need, or just hear out their problems or talk about mine. You know, that's very, very valuable, and something that, you know, a lot of people, you know, if you have a couple of close friends, you're very lucky to have. So that's something that I wanted to talk about first and foremost, and obviously my parents as well. But what I really wanted to talk about and what really makes me happy is gaming and YouTube. And I know that's probably very obvious, but you know, gaming has been like this cornerstone of my life. You know, when I think back to childhood and growing up and middle school especially, and early high school, and everything, there's always a game there that reminds me of my childhood. You know, I remember playing PlayStation 2 and GameCube and all these amazing games that basically shaped who I am. You know, I mean, the Pokemon series is huge, and I'm super excited for Sun and Moon to come out. I wish November would get here sooner, but I can't wait for that, obviously. And then we have, you know, it's just one-off, like, classics that I absolutely love. You know, Tony Hawk's series, you know, the Underground 2 games, those are amazing. SSX Tricky, that game is a snowboarding game. If you haven't played it, it's amazing. It was for the PS2 and GameCube. The whole Mario series, Mario Tennis and Mario Party and Smash Bros. I mean, it's just, all these games were just so good. I know there's Tai the Tasmanian Tiger, which was like this platforming game on the GameCube, and PS2 and Xbox, which is amazing. And all these just games, obviously Call of Duty, you know, I've played so many hours of Call of Duty in my life, and it was great. I used to play wrestling games back in the day, and Yu-Gi-Oh games, and all this stuff, and, you know, it's been this huge, like, it's just, I can't even put into words how, you know, how impactful it's been on my life, just, you know, basically continuing to enhance my creativity and my imagination and, you know, my positivity, because, you know, some of these games, you know, they can take you away from real life. When life gets really hard, you know, video games are there to, you know, I can immerse myself in them, especially games like, you know, the Elder Scrolls series and Fallout and things like that, where, you know, if just life is stressful and you're not really having it, you can put in these games, you can play them, and kind of just forget about, you know, some of the harsh realities of life at the moment, and just it kind of takes you away, puts you in this fantasy world where, you know, monsters are real and all this like crazy things, and there's just like dramatic storylines and this awesome writing and cinematics and just amazing graphics, and you get to, you know, experience things that you could never do in real life. And you know, it's just such an amazing hobby and a huge part of my life, obviously, and being able to take that to YouTube is like a dream for me. You know, if I did this as a job, that would be, you know, amazing, and that's what I'm grinding for. That's what this whole channel is about. You know, I would love to to have that. And I'm so thankful for everybody that's, you know, on my channel and watching my videos and supporting me. Lately, I've been getting like 180 to 220 views per video, which is just crazy to think about how many people are actually watching what I do here on YouTube, commentaries and opinions and tips on Call of Duty and you know, all this other stuff, you know. And YouTube, again, that is a huge thing, and I'm rambling now, but, you know, I'm gonna keep going. If you guys came here for the shout-out winners, they are in the description, you can check them out, but I'm gonna keep talking a little bit about things that I love, and that's the whole point of this contest, so... Again, YouTube is a thing that I've been watching since 2008 or 2007, whenever it first came out. I was on YouTube watching all sorts of, you know, different creators. I remember Philip DeFranco back in the day. I mean, he's still doing it, and he still makes videos, and I watch him occasionally. But that, I remember Fred, when Fred was the biggest YouTuber, and Smosh was, you know, big back in the day, but they're still big. And there's just, you know, all these different YouTubers, and... Growing up, I never really watched television shows because I always found YouTube more entertaining. You know, I always found channels that basically were what I was interested in at the time. You know, as I grew up and, you know, my some things changed about what I liked to do. You know, I used to watch a ton of Pokemon Let's Players and Battlers. I remember Hayden back in the day, you know, all these people that I used to watch. And then there were people like Mr. Repsion and The Amazing Atheist when I was, you know, looking into just the scientific reality and people talking about religious beliefs and talking about religion and disputing religion and all that stuff. And then I watched vlogging channels and I've watched, you know, Call of Duty. Obviously, you know, Wings of Redemption was like the first Call of Duty YouTuber that I ever watched, and I loved his commentaries and how he knew all about the different guns, and I could relate to him because, you know, he also loved Call of Duty just as much as me, and YouTube was new back then, and he was so good at Modern Warfare 2. And I was like, holy shit, dude, this guy's amazing. So I would watch him and X-Jaws and, you know, T-Martin, all these other people back in the day for Call of Duty. And it's just, it's been a crazy experience. Just every day I feel like I find a new channel, or back in the day, at least, I would find a new channel or new people to watch on YouTube. And it's just this awesome platform where I've been able to grow up for like 8 years now watching YouTube videos instead of television shows, because I just always found it a lot more entertaining for me, at least, you know, with being able to just choose the specific thing that I want to watch, and it was on demand. You know, I could immediately just go on YouTube and be like, okay, I want to watch something about religious beliefs, or I want to watch something about political talks, or I want to you know, watch a Let's Play of Elder Scrolls Oblivion or something like that, you know, Fables, anything. So it's just been this awesome, you know, it's just been this awesome platform. And the fact that these two massive things in my life, you know, the gaming, the whole gaming video game thing, part of me and my childhood and growing up and all that stuff, and then the whole YouTube aspect of it being like this massive source of entertainment for me, both of these things collide, and I'm able to participate in the same platform that used to entertain me growing up and still does to this day. You know, when I make lunch or dinner and I'm home alone and I'm eating, I always go to YouTube and I always click on Nadeshot's latest video or something else, or iJustine or whatever, and I watch YouTube instead of a TV show, because I just prefer that content. And, you know, the fact that I now have the ability and the experience and the knowledge to play the games that I love and record them and actually upload my own content to this platform is amazing. And that's something that I'm super grateful for, I'm super proud of, and I'm super, you know, it's a very positive thing in my life. And again, I thank you guys so much for being there and watching my content and helping me to grow, and all the encouragement. You guys are incredible with the encouragement. I get so many DMs and people in the comment section saying, like, you know, this is a great video, or people tell me that I'm their new favorite YouTuber and all this stuff. And obviously I'm a tiny channel, and I'm still growing, but the amount of support that I've seen so far has just been incredible. And for people to tell me that, like, you know, my content is just as good as people with hundreds of thousands or millions of subscribers is really encouraging to me. And it lets me know that I'm doing something right and that I'm connecting with the people that I'm making these videos for. And I'm also putting in the work to actually make the, you know, the videos look professional, look like I care and put time and effort into it, because I do. You know, each video takes a long time for me to make. So the fact that people actually realize that and appreciate that is super, super encouraging for me, and I really love all that positive feedback. And that's why I'm always responding to DMs, and I'm always talking to people in comments, and people are like, they're so confused as to how, you know, they feel like lucky that I'm responding to them, which is so weird to me, because, you know, obviously, you know, if you're a huge fan of like Nadeshot or something, and he responds to your tweet or something, that's awesome, because he gets thousands of tweets a day, you know, people talking, trying to talk to him and things like that, and obviously he can't talk to everybody. But I consider myself a really small YouTuber, so when people DM me and stuff, I always message them back, or at least I try to message everybody back, because I'm super grateful that anybody would watch me. And the fact that people say like, oh my god, like, I can't believe you actually responded, most YouTubers don't respond, like, no, like, the reason that I do this is because I want that connection with my viewers. Like, that's the whole point of all this, you know what I mean? Like, that's why I'm doing it, is to connect with you guys. And if you guys want to talk to me in DMs, or if you want to talk to me in comments or something like that, you know, I try to always respond back, because it's like, you're the whole reason that I'm doing it. You're the whole reason that there's actually growth on my channel. You know, you're the reason that I film these videos and upload them and things like that. So I can't just ignore that. You know, I can't just pretend like, oh, you know, I didn't see it, or I'm too good for that, man. I'm too good, man. I can't respond to everybody. Like, if I can, and while I still can, because, you know, as I get bigger, it's gonna get harder and harder to respond to everybody. So while I can, I'm obviously gonna talk to as many people a day, and it takes a lot of my time up. You know, I know sometimes I'll catch myself just on Twitter, even though I'm, you know, doing something else, or I should be focusing my attention on something else. You know, I'll be responding to DM after DM, or I'll be responding to people in comments, and it takes a lot of my time up, but I'm glad to do it, because, you know, you guys make this possible. You make my growth possible, and you're slowly making like my dream of becoming this gaming YouTuber possible, and I'm super, super grateful for that. So I know that's super cheesy, super corny, and I've been talking for a long ass time, but hopefully you guys understand that I'm incredibly grateful for every single one of you that watches my videos, that subscribes to my channel, that likes the videos. You know, that stuff means the world to YouTubers like me, especially tiny ones trying to grow. And my goal is to grow a huge channel in the year 2016, when people think that it's not possible. You know, there's a ton of people that think that getting huge on YouTube is not really possible anymore. You know, there's so much competition on the platform, there's so many people trying to do what I do, and people just, you know, a lot of people just get discouraged because they don't think it's possible. You know, there's too much competition, the market is too saturated, and they don't think that they can do it. I want to prove that it's still possible, and you guys are helping me do that, and it's been crazy. You know, I remember having 100 subscribers, 200 subscribers, you know, just being tiny on this channel, and I'm still tiny, but I have 10 times that now, which is just absolutely insane. You know, the come up from the beginning of Advanced Warfare has just been crazy, and lately there's been so much support on this channel, and I can't thank you guys enough. And obviously, this has been a very long, I don't want to say rant, because it wasn't really a rant, it was just a heartfelt talk about positivity and what makes me happy. So hopefully you guys enjoyed the video. I'm gonna shut up now, I'm done talking, and that's about it. So again, if you're still here, make sure you like the video and check out all the people in the description. Those four winners, I think you'll enjoy their content. Go check them out. They really deserve more subscribers. Like I said, they have 20 subscribers, 65, 75 subscribers. They deserve more. So again, I remember being that small. I know how hard it is, and it's still incredibly hard to grow. So if you guys can go check them out, give them a chance. Hopefully you guys will enjoy the content just like I do, and that's it, guys. So hopefully you enjoyed. If you did, again, make sure you leave a rating, subscribe to my channel if you're new around here, and comment down below letting me know what makes you happy. Also let me know if you checked out those channels, and that's about it, guys. So I'm so thirsty, I'm out of breath, and I'm out of mouth moisture. I've been talking too much. So that's a bit, guys. Hopefully you enjoyed. Thank you so much for watching and sticking around and supporting me through this whole thing. So I'm going to shut up now. I will talk to you later. Have a great day. And that's about it. Thanks for watching. Omniarch out. Peace.